By 1965, the Righteous Brothers were firmly entrenched as the first of the great blue-eyed soul acts, a descriptive phrase that quickly became part of the jargon of rock and roll.
Our second album was called Blue-Eyed Soul. Maybe that's where it came from.
I don't know. There's 15 or 16 different stories. A disc jockey somewhere
started calling us his Blue-Eyed Soul Brothers. We both have blue eyes. Maybe that's... We never really got down to the bottom of where that originated from, but our I guess we were as responsible for it as anybody, whether or not we wanted to be. I mean, we didn't go out and say, let's coin a national phrase, although that's kind of hip to be able
that
to
is, huh?
coin a national
I
phrase.
Bill and Bobby became famous because of their soulful sound, but it also caused them a few problems.
We had a couple of records yanked from a few stations that played only black records and wouldn't even make an exception. I mean, it was kind of a difficult decision for them because maybe we'd be on their top 40 at number 10 or something like that, and then they found out, obviously, when we go into the station and to promote an album or something like that, they say, oh, yank it.
Yeah, we would have been better. We would have had a bigger hit if we would have stayed at home.
Yeah, right.
At the height of their career, almost every song the Righteous Brothers recorded became a standard. For instance, even though Ebb Tide had already been a small hit for Bobby Freeman, The Platters, and Lenny Welsh, it was the Righteous Brothers who took it to the top of the charts.
Ebb Tide was another one of those, of course, that is a classic song. I mean, that's been around since Bill. That's a song.
Not nearly that long.
No. That also was, it was Unchained Melody and Ebb Tide were both, weren't they in the splitting up department right when Phil and us started heading a different direction?
Yeah, just about the same time. You say Ebb Tide is like really the right follow-up to Unchained Melody for some reason. I really think Roy Hamilton had hit with Unchained Melody and then Ebb Tide, and I also think Al Hibbler did too.
I think they both
and
did
I think
too.
I'm going to next year.
Yeah, right.
And after Ebb Tide came their second number one, Soul and Inspiration.
Girl, I can't let you do this, let you walk away. Girl, how can I live through this when you're all I wake up for each day, baby? You're my soul and my heart's inspiration. You're all I got to get me high. You're my soul and my heart's inspiration. Without you, baby, good girl of mine.
Soul and Inspiration was written by Barry Mann and Cynthia. And it was supposed to be the follow-up to You've Lost That Lovin' Feelin'. And apparently Phil and Barry and Cynthia had some sort of a fallout. And they were teaching us the song. And all of a sudden, we weren't learning that song anymore. And we were sent back to California to start learning Just Once in My Life. And when we left, or when we had the splitting with Phil Spector, we went to MGM. And I was going to produce the Righteous Brothers, so I called Barry and said, where's that great song that you were teaching us before Just Once in My Life? He says, oh, no, no. He says, I got a lot better song. I said, please, where is that song?
Righteous Brothers put everything they had into soul and inspiration. After that huge hit, their career started to take a downward spiral until they finally decided to call it quits in 1968.
We were out there for a long time. We spent a lot of time on the road. Maybe we just felt that we were getting a little bit stale.
Bill Medley went solo and had a few small hits with songs like Brown Eyed Woman and Peace, Brother, Peace. Bobby Hatfield continued the Righteous Brothers, replacing Bill with singer Jimmy Walker. And then in 1974, they decided that it might be fun to be brothers again.
I think we'd been apart, like 6 years or whatever it was, and it just felt real good. Our lives had changed quite a bit, and it was the perfect time. Neither one of us, we just got out of our recording contracts and everything, and we literally could start fresh, which we did, and it was fun.
And the song they came back with was a top three smash called Rock and Roll Heaven.
Jimmy gave us rainbows, and Janice took a piece of our heart. And Otis brought us all to the dock of the bay.
Rock and Roll Heaven was brought to us by our producers at the time, Dennis Lambert and Brian Potter. And it was, there it was, it was one of those songs that, it wasn't a Righteous Brothers song, definitely. I mean, it wasn't the meaty type of song that we had.
Trouble with the words aren't flowing.
No, they're not flowing. It's too. It's a nice little song. It was a
good little ditty.
Good little ditty. Oh, I mean, it helped. Helped our career at the time. It was during our second reunion. We got to stop reuniting like this.
The Righteous Brothers, like Elvis Presley before them, rearranged the boundaries between white and black music. Yet, as far as they were concerned, all they did was to sing some nice songs.
I don't think we've ever sat still long enough to sit back and say, hey, we accomplished quite a bit in our time. I think we're basically the same two people that we were when we started out. I mean, we're a little bit older, but I think our minds are shooting about in the same direction. But it's nice to, it's nice even to be on this program, a legend.
Yeah.
I do think that, and this is probably as far out as I'm going to get with a pat on our own backs, which is a dumb way to put it, but it's the only thing that, and I do think, however, that You've Lost That Love and Feeling was a classic record. That is almost a legendary record.
I would say that's
about as close as I can feel to get to, as to becoming a legend.
We had a love you don't find every day. So don't let it slip away. Oh, baby, Bring back that feeling, 'cause it's gone.
The Righteous Brothers were responsible for some of the greatest songs of the rock era. Classics like You've Lost That Lovin' Feelin', Unchained Melody, Ebb Tide, and Soul and Inspiration. Now, just one of those songs would qualify any act for greatness, and a whole string of them definitely marked Bill Medley and Bobby Hatfield as legends.